There is a beautiful story in Shiva Purana, the history of Shiva, the Purana of Shiva. It says that when a poison was brought to him by the demons and angels, he just drank, he filled himself with that poison. Then the story says the poison stayed in the throat, it did not go to his center, go to his very being. The meaning of the story is, words are just like poison. They have to stay in your throat. They can't go to your center. They can't lead you to your center. If you follow the words, naturally you will start experiencing the experiences of the outer world, which will create more and more words. If you go to the periphery, if you go to the outer world, you will see a deep dissatisfaction, and not only that, feeling of emptiness, feeling that something is not there, something is missing. Instead, if you start traveling towards the root of the words, towards the depth from where they are happening, suddenly you will see, you start experiencing a different space, different consciousness, altogether different being. The very frequency of your being becomes totally different. Just the other day, one of our Swamis brought a beautiful question to me. Swamiji, in the West, all the spiritual groups are saying, you can't have enlightenment without sex. All the tantric groups, they insist, celibates can never achieve enlightenment. Celibacy can only lead to suppression. The other day we had a program, 10 days workshop in India. Many of our Swamis were sitting inside the fire and meditating. The program is called Brahmacharyam. They were sitting inside the fire and meditating to intensify the consciousness, to experience their depth. After that program only this question was brought to me. All tantrics, especially the tantra practiced in the Western countries, all of them say suppression will lead only to more and more problems. It can't lead to enlightenment. And there is another big group, the yogis, the followers of Patanjali, they say without celibacy enlightenment is impossible. Forget about it. What's the truth, Swamiji? Actually, both are true. That is where the problem starts. We always think only one can be true. Both are true. It depends on the frequency of the individual. Sometime, you travel following the thoughts, trying to fulfill them. Then you learn many things. That experience tells you to go inside, to the root of the thoughts. Then naturally, you will listen the call of consciousness. You will attend the right phone. You will attend the right phone. This is like you have 4 or 5 phones in front of you. You hear the ringtone. Pick up one by one. Finally, you come upon the right phone and you answer. The other one, another one group, who doesn't have to travel along with the thoughts, who can straight away travel to the depth, to the core of the thoughts, they never try to fulfill, they never try to learn the meaning of the words which is happening in you. The meaning of the words which is happening in you is meaningless for them. For them, the root of the words is the life, not the meaning of the words. Man who tries to go behind the meaning of the words misses the source of the words. Only two things can happen in your life. Either you follow the meaning of the words or the source of the words. Person who travels towards the source of the words, he can achieve enlightenment just by celibacy, brahmacharya. He doesn't need to go through the experiences. But for that, the frequency of your consciousness, the frequency of your very being should be totally different. And there is another group which insists that you should have the experience of the outer world. Without that, it is impossible. This group is trained to work only with the meaning of the words. They never experienced the source. Not only they never experienced, they were never taught you need to go to the source of the words. All the social systems, all the schools, all the education systems around the world teaches you that you are not enough unto yourself. Constantly you need to learn more words and go behind the meaning of the words. You are taught in your schools, colleges, universities only to go behind the meaning of the words, never to the source of the words. Because you are trained to go behind the meaning of the words, the tantra system says, go behind the meaning of the words. The very meaning will, what you think as meaning will show you that your words are meaningless. The words which are happening in you are meaningless. If you sit and see what all is happening in you, what you think as pleasure, what you think as life, whatever you think as the base of your life, meaning of your life, when you achieve them, experience them, if you are conscious, when you go through the experience for which you spend your whole life, suddenly you will see that they are meaningless. Suddenly you will find the depth is not there. Always you thought that there is something. When you go into it, when that is happening in you, you feel it's not the thing which you are searching. So there is something missing. Something more needs to happen in you. That something missing is what I call call of your consciousness. Constantly, your consciousness makes you feel that you need to come in, you need to come in, you need to come in. You are not enough. The words or the thoughts are a method your consciousness is using to get your attention towards it. But the big difficulty, you miss that call and start working in a different direction. Even the pains which is happening in your body is call from your consciousness. You are being called. Even the sufferings, what you think as sufferings happening in your being is call from your consciousness. That's a beautiful saying. You can use all the pains or sufferings either to escape from that pain or suffering, or to escape from all kinds of pains and sufferings. If you attend only that problem, you may move away, escape from that suffering. But if you go little deeply and see the root of the problem, any problem, if you analyze the root, you will come to the clear understanding. The root of the disease is the disease of samsara, the bondage. Bondage, that you feeling that you are this body. You feeling the thoughts which are happening in you are meaningful. That is where the problem starts. The more you believe thoughts which are happening in you are meaningful, you get clutched with them, you get connected with them, you are caught with them. The more you believe the words are true, the more you will start believing world is true. It's like a self-hypnosis. You can hypnotize yourself and feel it is true. But one great thing, however, how much you try to hypnotize yourself, whatever technique or method society may use to hypnotize you, society may use to create a lifestyle around you, your consciousness never stops calling. Constantly you are called. You may be attending the wrong phones. You may be doing many other things, but it never stops calling you. It never stops calling you. Maya means the social setup all human beings are created. It's a kind of a self-hypnosis. A group of human beings, the thoughts, understandings, lifestyle created by them is what I call Maya, which does not exist, but which gives you the feeling or the experience as if it exists. It's just like a self-hypnosis. For example, if you all just close your eyes and give a suggestion, strong suggestion to yourself that you can't open your hands, just close your hands and give a suggestion to yourself for 5 minutes continuously. You can't open your hands, they are tight, they are permanently closed, locked. After 5 minutes, 30% of you will not be able to open. Actually, 30% of the population are powerful enough to hypnotize themselves. You have the power to hypnotize yourself. The other 30% needs the help of some charismatic leader. A charismatic leader, if he gives the suggestion, the other 30% also starts experiencing the same thing. The last 30% needs intense contemplation or concentration. With a self-suggestion and a charismatic leader's guidance and a deep contemplation, a continuous contemplation, you can create anything which is not there. That is why the Vedic system is using all these three to bring you out of the same hypnosis. You are caught inside this Maya, inside this network, with these three things only: suggesting, creating your own suggestions, and the political and social system created around you, and constantly working with that system. These 3 years only created a Maya, a sort of a self-hypnosis, a sort of a network in which you are caught. The network of words, constantly trying to find meaning in words, constantly trying to follow the words which are created in your consciousness, in your inner space. Now you need to do just the opposite. Instead of trying to find the meaning of the words, trying to find the source of the words, the Vedic system, Vedic rishis are using the same method which society is using. Human beings have used these three things to put you in Maya. When a group of human beings believe a particular things, that becomes a social lifestyle, that becomes a social system. When you live in that system, you also start believing it by suggesting it for yourself and by listening it from the political leader or social leader and by working with that system again and again. All these three are used by the Vedic masters to lead you to enlightenment, to take you away from the Maya, to take you away from the misunderstanding. In Vedic system they say, first analyze the truth by yourself. Second, be with the master, means a charismatic being who can impress you, who can show you the truth. Third, work with the truth by analyzing and contemplating and meditating on it. The same way how the society is created, how the Maya is created, the same things are used in a different direction to liberate you. The society which is created around you asks you to travel towards the words, asks you to work behind the meaning of the words. If you know more words, you are respected. If you look little deep, in any field, whether it is politics, business, or spirituality, in any field, people who knows more words, they shine. Who can express, who can use many words, they become leaders. But in the inner world, knowing more words or going behind the meaning of the words is not going to help you. You need to totally travel in a different direction, the direction of the source of the words. You need to listen to the call of your consciousness. Your consciousness is calling you constantly. Sometimes by creating words, sometimes by creating a deep empty feeling. Even the deep empty feeling which happens in you for no reason. People come to me and they ask me, Swamiji, many times I experience a depression for no reason. There is no reason. I have everything. I have everything, whatever I want, I have around me. But I feel deep depression. What's the reason? I tell them, you will experience this depression because you have everything you want. If you don't have, you will have a hope. You will be running behind that. Let me have this. Let me have that. Let me have this. I want that. You will be running behind that. You will not have time to have depression. You will not have your inner space for depression. Only when you have whatever you can have, suddenly you will see you are not having something which is needed for life, which is necessary for life. When you go towards the source of words, you will see words disappears.